Welcome to the Hydraulic Press channel. Today we are here at outdoors. Long time no see the 40 ton MKH press. But today we are going to use it because we have really messy video. We are going to find out how many soda cans it takes to stop 10 ton hydraulic press. And yes, this is 40 ton press, but we can't fit enough soda cans probably for that. So we are going to dial it back into 10 tons, but that's still a lot of force. Like 10 tons in metric, and I think in like freedom units, that's like 3 blue whales minus 1 bus and 3-story building and 1 tennis field. Or something like that. But 10 tons and this many pounds. Yeah. I think we are going to try first with 3Ts, see how it starts to go and then start to fit more. Okay, I dialed back the pressure of the machine to 80 bars. That's 1/4 of the full pressure. So that's also 1/4 of the force. So 10 tons. And it's not going to have any problems with 3 cans. But I want to check the high speed camera settings and stuff like that. It's good to practice. And it should look really nice because we have bright sunshine. So we are running 5,500 frames per second with the fancy chronos. So nice high speed shot coming. Those were really colorful, looks really unhealthy.
Yeah.
Yeah, also the cameras are completely ruined. So we are going to dry this up and then add shitload of more cans under the press.
Mm.
Okay, we are ready for the next one. Now we have 9 cans. And this is going to be the setup that we are going to use from now on. 2 really thick steel plates and the cans go between them. And I assume that they are not going to bend much, so the load is going to be evenly spread for all the cans, so they should explode in one go. But let's see. That was quite funny actually. Yeah, let's go all in. Let's add as many as we can there. Okay, there they are, 28 cans. And this is actually more interesting than you thought. Because if they would be 28 times as strong as one can is, that wouldn't be enough. But I hope that they're going to support each other there. So it's going to be really close. What is, Hanna, your opinion? Are they going to survive 10 tons?
I think they are going to survive.
Yeah, but if they survive, I of course just crank the machine up. Mm. But let's try with the 10 tons. Okay, can 28 soda cans stop 10 ton hydraulic press? Here we go. I'm going to add 5 tons more. Actually, I can't see how much I'm adding. I just add a lot. Now they're going to go. But I try to look the pressure meter.
Oh,
that was like 110 parts when they started to fly. That was actually way more fun than I thought. Yeah, let's have a look on the replays. We have a lot of great high-speed replays.
Okay, here comes the Kronos. And I have to say that the 5000 frames per second, that was way too much for this. This takes forever if you play it 25 frames per second. So I'm fast forwarding now and then. And also, the cans were a bit in the shadows. And then the white foam is really bright on the sun. And it's interesting that like they first explode from like front row and then on the back rows. I think that's just coincidence, because after one can goes, then that side is weaker than the other side. And as a comparison, here is just one can with force sensor. And as you can see, these are not as strong when they're alone, compared when you have a lot of them. And I think that's because when they start to go, they spread slightly, like the diameter gets larger from those ripples. And when they are packed really tightly, they need more pressure to make those, or like they are not able to make those in the middle. And I think that's going to make them stronger, because I think the ripples make it weaker. There is sharp bend on the aluminium can. And let's see, can we see here what happens? Yeah, now they start to get crushed. The ripples come towards the camera, of course, but it's hard to say what happens there in the middle of everything. Yeah, really hard to say. But nevertheless, they were stronger together, and that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.